All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Dr. Seth Lederman. He is the CEO of Tonix Pharmaceuticals. And Dr. Lederman, welcome back. Nice to see you again.
Thank you for having me on, Steve.
Absolutely. And excited to talk about a report that the company put in a press release from the U.S. National Academies of Sciences, Engineering, and Medicine. And maybe tell me a bit more about this organization. They're a pretty prestigious group.
Yes, the National Academies of Science is a unique organization and plays an important role in interpreting science for policymakers, legislators, and government officials. In this case, the National Academies convened a committee to define long COVID. Long COVID is an extremely common and complex disorder. In this case, the National Academies, in their new report, defined long COVID as a chronic condition following COVID that could be comprised of a number of different diagnosable conditions within it. And this has really shed light on long COVID and allowed scientists, drug developers, and policymakers to move forward to try to really start to tackle the long COVID problem.
And so how does this then relate then to your development candidate TNX-102 SL?
Well, it was known that many people with long COVID had features of their illness that overlapped with fibromyalgia. But what the National Academy's new definition of long COVID allows is that fibromyalgia can be diagnosed in long COVID people. So this means that people suffering from long COVID who meet the criteria of fibromyalgia in their recommendation should be diagnosed with fibromyalgia. And that is a very big breakthrough, because prior to this, there was a lot of ambiguity about if someone had long COVID, could they have fibromyalgia? And if someone had fibromyalgia, could they have long COVID? And this definition, the new definition of the National Academies, is inclusive, meaning that someone who meets the criteria of fibromyalgia can and should be diagnosed with fibromyalgia, whether or not they have long COVID.
And Dr. Lederman, this now opens up a potential opportunity as well. And that's the reasoning behind putting this report out, correct?
Yes. We already are targeting an addressable market of about 10 million American adults with fibromyalgia. And when I say we are targeting it, Tonix is in late stage development. We're filing the new drug application for TNX-102 SL, which is a new treatment for fibromyalgia. We have two statistically significant studies. We've met with the FDA for pre-NDA meetings, and we recently were awarded FDA Fast Track designation, which is reserved for important new drugs that address serious conditions in which there's an unmet need. So we've been working on fibromyalgia for many years as a company, and I've been working on fibromyalgia for almost 30 years, not only at this company, but before that in another company and as an academic. So I'm very interested in fibromyalgia, and I think that what this new report allows is that the approximately 14 million Americans who suffer from long COVID, now some of them who meet the criteria for fibromyalgia, can be diagnosed with fibromyalgia and treated with some of the approved fibromyalgia medicines.
Yeah. It really is fascinating stuff for sure. Dr. Lederman, thank you so much. Great update, and I really appreciate your time and updating us on this.
Thank you very much.
All right, Dr. Seth Lederman, the CEO of Tonix Pharmaceuticals.